Hey everyone, welcome back or welcome to my channel if you're new here. So today's case is actually one that has been getting a lot of media attention, and I usually like to stay away from those cases because they're already getting the coverage that they need, and so I'd rather highlight a case that isn't getting so much attention. But this case has caught me since the beginning. I've been so invested in finding this girl, and so I really felt like I needed to highlight it. There are so many weird twists and turns when it comes to this case, and there's a really strange cast of characters surrounding it as well, and I think that you guys will be really interested and definitely want to help find little Summer Wells. So with all that being said, I'm just gonna get into the case and my usual disclaimer. So all the information that I'm reporting on is public information that anyone has access to. All the opinions expressed are my own and not fact, and all of the information that I have is linked down below in the sources. Now, let's get into it. Summer Wells is 5 years old and from Rogersville, Tennessee, which is a very small and close-knit town. She was born to parents Candace Bly Wells and Donald Wells and has three older brothers who she lives with, along with her grandmother, who lives in a nearby house on the same property as the family. Currently, Summer isn't attending school, but her mother said that she was enrolled to start kindergarten in this upcoming fall. As for her personality, Summer, like most girls her age, including myself when I was her age, loves Disney princesses and especially Frozen, and was known to dress up as Elsa and some of the other princesses. Her family was also really involved in their church, and Summer was said to have loved going to church and really look up to the women in her church and just have really close relationships with these women. However, although Summer had that girly side to her, she was also said to be a tomboy and like roughing around with her brothers and playing around in the mud and just getting dirty. And she also had just shaved her head before her disappearance because her mom has a shaved head and her brothers have shaved heads, and it said that she wanted to look like them, which I totally understand. I remember being that age and I always wanted to look like my sister and do what she was doing, so that's very relatable. Speaking of Summer and her brothers, it said that she was closest to her youngest brother, which is 9 years old, and that the two would play together all the time and were pretty much inseparable, which is understandable because they were the closest in age and so they had the most in common. However, there have been a lot of rumors online saying that her brothers were rough with her and they like to roughhouse and shoot BB guns. However, this hasn't been confirmed. This is just speculation, so we don't really know if this is true. So now, leading up to Summer's disappearance, Candace took her mother, so Summer's grandmother, to knee surgery on the morning of the 15th of June. At 2 p.m. that same day, Summer was last seen by someone not a part of the family at a swimming spot called Warrior Path State Park. This sighting was by a 15-year-old family friend who had gone with Candace's mother, and Summer to this spot without Summer's brothers. Candace has spoken about this 15-year-old being with them, and she says that the reason why he went with them that day was because he was having trouble with his grandmother, and so she decided to take him with them to go swimming while they were waiting for her mother's prescription for her knee medication because she had just had surgery. However, according to the mother of this 15-year-old boy, the story goes a little bit differently. She said that Candace showed up to her house that morning and asked if her son could go swimming with her daughter Summer. Now, this wasn't unusual because she says her son and Summer had a really close relationship and that they were like brother and sister, so it was normal for them to go swimming and fishing together. So she says that her son went and the two went swimming and fishing, and then she says that Candace dropped off her son at around 2 or 2:15 p.m. and she says at that time Summer was in the back seat asleep when she dropped off her son. Now, there have been a lot of rumors surrounding this trip to Warrior Path State Park and surrounding this 15-year-old boy and his relationship to Summer's family, and a lot of people thought it was weird that this 15-year-old boy would be going with Candace and her mom and this little girl Summer without, you know, any of the brothers or anyone else. And there have also been rumors saying that Candace gave this boy alcoholic beverages during this trip. However, this has not been confirmed. This is just online speculation. speculation that keeps being thrown around, but if this is true, that is extremely inappropriate, and I have no idea why she would do this, and that really raises questions on the events of the day. Now, getting back to Summer's disappearance, the family have said that they last saw her on Tuesday, June 15th at 6:30 p.m. outside of her home, which is located on the 100 block of Ben Hill Road in Rogersville, Tennessee. So after the swimming trip, according to her family, Summer was said to be in the front yard with her mother and grandmother planting. The three of them then went inside after they were done planting for a while, and Summer was said to have washed her hands and her grandmother gave her a piece of candy. Then Candace says that Summer decided that she wanted to stop planting and go inside to see her brothers. So Candace says she walked her over to the front porch of the house. She then says she watched Summer walk into the kitchen where her brothers were watching TV. Next, Candace says that she told Summer's brothers to watch her while she goes out for a bit. And so 2 minutes later, she says that she comes back and she asks the brothers where Summer was, and they claimed that she was in the basement playing with her toys. A few moments later, Candace says that she went down to the basement and tried to find Summer, but she was nowhere in sight. She says the basement door was also left open, so she called Summer's father, Donald, who then reported her missing to the police. A lot of people have been suspicious and critical of the fact that Candace didn't report her daughter missing herself, since she was the one who found her to be missing and had Donald do it instead. However, I don't think this is that big of a deal because she could have just been frantic and trying to deal with Summer's siblings as well, you know, with all of the chaos that was going on. So I'm really not sure that this is that important of a detail. In a strange turn of events, the call that Donald made to the dispatch that day when he was calling in Summer missing has been released, and it completely contradicts the family story. In this call, Donald says that Candace was out for a walk or a run when Summer was missing, and this is completely different from what she says because she claims that she was just out for 2 minutes and then came back, and if she were out on a run or a walk, I would think that it would have been a longer time span of 2 minutes that she would be doing this. So it seems like she was gone for longer and she was actually going somewhere as opposed to just standing in the front yard again where she was earlier planting flowers. Candace has commented on this discrepancy though, and she claims that this isn't true, that she was on a walk or a run, and she thinks that Donald may have been confused because she would never go for a walk or run around the property because she's apparently scared of the animals around there. But I don't get why she would be planting in the front yard if she's so scared of the animals on the property, because animals can come up from the ground when you're planting, such as snakes or other animals. So it seems like that would not be something she would do if this were true. Another really strange inconsistency in the story is that the dispatcher says that Donald called them from his work, which is located about an hour away from the family's home. However, he still arrived back to the house before police did, who went to the house as soon as possible and as soon as they got the call, and they are located closer to the house than he was, so it really seems strange that he would arrive there quicker than they would. This has gone unexplained and makes people question the whereabouts of Donald that day because they don't believe he could have gotten there so fast if he was actually at work. At 11:09, the same night of Summer's disappearance, the TBI issued an endangered child alert, which was then changed to an Amber Alert the next day, and it triggered a statewide search for her. This search for Summer has been difficult, to say the least, due to the hot weather and rugged terrain where she lives. Summer's family's home is located next to an 11-acre wooded area, which means that if she did wander off, there's a lot of area to cover and places she could be hiding. There's a fear that if Summer wandered off, that she could be hurt or lost in this terrain or dehydrated due to the heat, and that they might not be able to find her still because of how rural the area is. Still, they have conducted numerous land, water, and aerial searches that have all come up empty-handed. There's really only been one major lead or tip in this case that police have announced to the public. The TBI says that there was a 1998 to 2000 maroon or red Toyota Tacoma that was seen in the Beach Creek Road and Ben Hill Road area on the day of Summer's disappearance. Police have said that this person isn't a suspect and that they just want to talk to them and want them to come forward in case they saw something that day that could lead them to Summer's whereabouts. As for the family's involvement in the search, police have said that they've been very cooperative and allowed police to search both the house and the area surrounding the house multiple times without needing them to get a search warrant. Police have also said that they've searched the house for any signs of abduction, such as forced entry, but they haven't found anything leading them to believe that there is an abduction, so there's been no forced entry or any kind of strange footprints or anything left behind by a possible abductor. Despite this, police are still focusing their search efforts in the area surrounding Summer's house, which makes me believe that they might know more than they're saying because they are focusing so many resources and energy in this area, and they wouldn't do so if they didn't believe that she could be there. However, the family is adamant that they don't believe that Summer is in this area around the house anymore and that they believe that she's very far away. On Thursday, June 17th, Donald, Summer's dad, spoke out to the media for the first time. He says that he believes that Summer would not have left her home on her own free will, and that he believes that Summer was abducted and could be trafficked, and that he even thinks that a Facebook trafficking ring could be involved. Next, on June 21st, the FBI actually joined in the search for Summer. Interestingly, they came out and said that they haven't found any evidence that leads them to believe that Summer was abducted. However, they're not completely ruling this theory out. This is really interesting because it makes me think that either they have found evidence that goes against the abduction theory or that they found evidence that goes towards a different theory, so thus the abduction theory isn't reliable anymore. While the searches for Summer have continued, the most recent and last public announcement from police came on July 9th when Sheriff Lawson came out and said that this case is nowhere close to being cold and that they're working around the clock to hopefully find Summer. This is really good news because it makes me think that this case is solvable and hopefully soon we will find Summer and bring her home. Now that I have the timeline for this case set out for you guys, I'm gonna take a slight detour, but it's still related to Summer's case, and go into the case of her aunt, who is also missing, named Rosemary Bly. She went missing in 2009 at the age of 21, and I find it really strange that this family has not one, but two people missing at the same time. Rose is described as a loving and caring mom of two daughters who had dreams of becoming a children's author. She was last seen on August 21st, leaving her house in St. Croix Falls in Wisconsin after having dinner with her husband and her father-in-law. According to Rose's husband, Christopher Lawson, she left the house at 7:30 p.m. that night, and she says that she had plans to meet her cousins for drinks in Cushing, Wisconsin, which was only a few miles away from their home. However, her cousins say that they didn't have plans that night and no one would ever see her again. Rose's last known communication happened sometime that night when she called her husband and told him that she would be home by midnight, and this has been corroborated by her cell phone records. 5 days later, Rose's car was found in a random parking lot in Grantsburg, Wisconsin, which is 30 miles north of St. Croix Falls. Now, the only connection known that Rose had to this place was that she went to high school there, and the place where her car was found was just a random parking lot known to be frequented by truckers that they didn't believe she had any connection to. When police found her car, they noticed that the keys were missing, and they also found some unidentified DNA in the car. They've since tested this DNA, and unfortunately, it doesn't match anyone in their database, so still to this day, this DNA has no match. In what seemed to be a really strange move, 3 weeks after Rose disappeared, her husband filed for divorce and also filed for an order so that Rose couldn't take the kids away from him. This wasn't the first weird thing in their relationship, as he had filed for divorce 2 months earlier, but then quickly rescinded because he believed that the two would work things out. This first divorce attempt was said to be brought on by a domestic incident that happened in June of that same year, in which Rose claims that her husband put her in a headlock and pushed her down, and Christopher Lawson claims that Rose slapped him. Because police had to come to break up this fight, Rose was charged with a misdemeanor domestic abuse charge. It's unclear why her husband wasn't charged as well, since it seems like he took part also in the fight. In July of 2009, so a month before she disappeared, Rose pled guilty to this charge. However, because this case was never officially finished or closed, there is still an active warrant out on Rose. So why am I bringing up this case and leading out all these facts that don't seem to have any relevance to Summer's case? Well, it's because I believe that the two cases could be related. I know police have said that there's no evidence that leads them to believe that the two are connected, But there are three main theories in this case, and one of these theories could possibly relate back to Summer and her case. The first theory is pretty obvious and straightforward. It's that her husband possibly had something to do with her disappearance. This is because the two did have a really tumultuous relationship and they were fighting a lot. However, he did take a polygraph test, and police have said that he passed the polygraph test and that he's not really a suspect anymore. So that leads me to believe that they could have evidence that, you know, gets him off the hook, and that looks like he didn't have any involvement. The second theory is that Rose just went off on her own. Now, her mother says that she suffered a head injury right before she disappeared, that she fell off a horse and hit her head really hard and seemed to be kind of out of it, you know, in the week leading to her disappearance. And so her mother believes that it is possible that she got out of her car and was confused and wandered off and possibly met with harm there. This is a possible theory. However, I believe if she had wandered off and she was confused, she probably wouldn't have gotten that far. So I'm not sure this is the most reliable of all the theories. Now, the third and final theory that could have some relation back to Summer's case is that Rose met with foul play from someone who police haven't been looking at. Now, if this person did do something to Rose and they weren't apprehended, obviously, because the case is still open, they could be out there to harm other people and thus could have involvement in Summer's case. Now, I know it's a bit of a stretch, but I think that if there was someone who, you know, had a bad relationship with the family or, you know, someone within the family who did this, I think that there is a possibility that the two cases could be related. You know, I've seen those videos, there's no such thing as a coincidence, you know, and I really do believe that. I think that, you know, there really is no such thing as a coincidence, and to have two people missing within the same family just seems like kind of too much of a coincidence to me. I don't know, it might be a stretch, and I know that there are probably more likely theories, but I do just find this weird that there would be two people who seemingly just vanish without a trace, you know, fall off the face of the earth. It's really rare for someone to do that just in general, let alone two people related to each other. So it makes me think that maybe there could be someone who did something to Rose who came back and, you know, did something to Summer. So speaking of Rose and Summer's family and their possible involvement in their disappearances, there has been a lot of speculation online that the family is involved in Summer's disappearance and that they've been just making up a story to cover up the whole thing. Now, people have been very harsh on social media, and Donald has done interviews saying that this has been really harmful towards the family. However, I do think that he kind of needs to put it in perspective and understand that his daughter is missing, and a lot of people are concerned, and the stories they're saying just aren't really adding up to a lot of people, and the facts are contradicting themselves, so of course people are going to be speculating. There have also been a lot of accusations thrown at Summer's parents, and the mother of the 15-year-old boy who went swimming with Summer that day has come out and said some pretty disturbing things about Donald and Candace, and has said that she heard them, you know, verbally abusing and berating their children, as well as physically abusing them, and, you know, actually witnessed it with her own two eyes. However, this is coming from, you know, a third source. We don't know what her motives are. We don't know if she has a vendetta against the family. However, she has said that she has witnessed this abuse, and if this is true, this really puts the family in a different light. Then there's the criminal history of Summer's parents that really make people suspicious. Donald was convicted for burglary and drug-related offenses, and recently, in October of 2020, Donald was arrested of domestic assault against Candace. Apparently, Donald was drunk and saw Candace with a man, and the two argued, ending with him getting physical with her. Because of this, Candace filed for an order of protection against Donald the next day, saying that he was abusive to her and that she was worried for her children's safety. This does kind of tie back into the 15-year-old mother's story, saying that there was abuse in the household and that the household was very turbulent and violent. Although Candace did ultimately end up dropping this order of protection, this still doesn't look good. Candace herself has been charged with domestic abuse before, which means that Summer has two parents with violent pasts, which really makes it likely that They have been violent before and could be violent in the future, and so that makes people really suspicious. Summer's parents aren't the only ones around her with a criminal past. Summer's half-brother, Donald Wesley Wells, is a convicted sex offender. This only adds to the potentially volatile environment that Summer was raised in. Adding to suspicions around her parents, people have really been picking apart their interviews, saying that they don't seem emotional, which I do agree with. They really aren't showing much emotion. However, there's really no one way to react to grief, so I'm not sure that this in itself is enough evidence to make them look guilty. There's also still the theory possibly that Summer has been abducted, like her parents are insisting. However, this seems extremely unlikely because Summer's house was really far off a main road and it was on a hill kind of far back. I'll insert a picture so you guys can kind of see where it's located. And as you guys can see, it's really far off the main road, and so someone would have to intentionally drive back there. They wouldn't normally just pass it en route to somewhere else. So this means that Summer would have had to be targeted, or that this person just randomly went down this, you know, weird road that they don't usually go down, just, you know, to see, and oh, they just so happened to stumble upon a little girl, and oh, they just so happened to be someone who would want to kidnap someone. So, you know, a lot of things would have to align perfectly for this to be the case, and it just seems really unlikely because it would have had to be the perfect circumstance for someone to do this. Also, because so few cars travel in this area, people definitely would have noticed it, and they also would have heard Summer's screams, or there would have been something possibly left behind in the struggle, or tire track marks, or footprints, or something, you know, some kind of physical sign that a car had been on this road and that a child had been there. But there really has been nothing, which leads people to believe that there wasn't an abduction there. Lastly, there's also the theory that Summer just wandered off on her own. However, again, I highly doubt this because there have been so many intense searches around the house, and you know, she's a small 5-year-old girl. She really couldn't get that far on her own. So it seems unlikely that she would be able to go so far that police wouldn't be able to find her, especially at this point when they've searched, you know, the entire area around her house. But unfortunately, that's really all we have in this case. There have been a lot more rumors that I didn't mention in this video, such as the rumor that the boys have been removed from the Wells house, you know, Summer's brothers have been removed by CPS and are living somewhere else, no longer with Donald and Candace. But again, this is just a rumor. I don't know if that's true. There have been a lot of other rumors about the family, but I think that we need to just focus on the facts here. And, you know, there is a lot of speculation, and I think it's good for us to, you know, do our due diligence and do research and try to find information to find Summer. But I think when it passes doing research and kind of turns into harassing the family, I think that's a fine line that we shouldn't cross. I'm not sure how else to wrap this video up other than to say that I really hope Summer's out there. Sadly, with all of this information, I don't think she is. It's been, you know, what, a couple months, and there's been no evidence of her being there. And I feel like if she were out there somewhere, there would be a sighting, or there would be some evidence leading us to believe that someone took her and has her somewhere. Sadly, I do think that there are people out there who know something and are covering things up, and I really hope soon that things will be brought to light. As for what I think, I really believe that her parents are hiding something. I don't know what, I don't know how big or small, but it really does seem like they are hiding something from the police. Their stories are changing, and I really hope that's not the case and that they're just nervous and they don't know what to say. But the fact that what they're saying isn't lining up with what the police are saying, it just seems a little sketchy to me. Personally though, I don't think that she was abducted by someone random. I think that if there was an abduction, it was someone that she knew and that she was targeted. I don't think that some random person just found her on Facebook Marketplace, like Donald saying. I don't know how that would have happened. And although I know there are, you know, trafficking rings out there, I really don't think that this is the case. She was only left alone for a few minutes, according to the family. So that seems extremely extremely unlikely. I do think that this case will be solved soon though, because the police have been working on this nonstop and devoting a lot of resources to it, as they should. And so hopefully that leads to something very soon and I'm able to update you guys on what happens. But that's all I have for you today, guys. Thank you so much for watching Summer Story, and be sure to like and subscribe for more true crime videos. Thanks so much again. Bye!